with an eternity of resources exposed, namely technologies, rules, policies, lifestyles, their work and much more, and the rest speak from the graves. Catering to this section is a study called archaeology. Archaeology is the sandbox of men who care not where they are going. They merely want to know where everyone else has been. An archaeologist, thus, is said to be the best husband a woman can have, because the older she gets, the more interested he is in her. Fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests, good evening. Having spoken of archaeology, my primary topic today is one of the many earth-shaking discoveries that our archaeologists have brought to us, the splendid Mayan civilization. We will be looking into what they spoke from the graves, or more subtly put, what is Mayan civilization, their achievements, and subsequently its demise. Starting off with the very basic, Maya civilization was one of the most indigenous societies of Mesoamerica, a turning point for Central America and Mexico before the 16th century Spanish conquest. Unlike the other Mesoamerican cultures, the Maya were located in one geographical area covering the whole of Yucatan Peninsula, parts of Mexico, El Salvador, and Honduras. To this date, there are estimated 7 million Maya living in this region. Some of them have very well blended in the Hispanicized cultures of the regions they reside, while the others live a more traditional, culturally distinct life, still speaking one of the Maya languages as their primary language. Looking back into the timeline, the earliest settlements of Maya date back to 1800 BC, or what is called the formative or the pre-classic period, and they lived till the 980. Maya saw its peak at around 600 AD. It is then that it grew to some 40 cities and had a population of 20 lakhs. The pre-classic city of Mirador in the northern Eden was one of the greatest cities built in the pre-Columbian Americas. This city dwarfed the size of the capital city of Tikal, and its existence is what proves that Maya flourished centuries before the classic period. Going deeper into Maya, we will now have a look upon the discoveries unleashed. Excavation of Maya sites revealed plazas, palaces, temples, and pyramids, as well as courts for ball games, which was ritually and politically significant to Maya culture. It was supported majorly by large number of farmers, even though they practiced a very primitive form of agriculture, slash and burn. They displayed evidence for complex methods of farming, such as irrigation and terrace farming. A lot of what they ate was corn. In fact, they had a god. This was called the god of corn. They also chiefly raised beans, avocados, sweet potatoes, and chili peppers. Guided by their religious ritual, the Maya also made significant advances in mathematics and astronomy, using the number zero and the development of the most complex calendar based on 365 days. It is this calendar that has given rise to the myth of the world coming to an end. Mayan mythology. According to Mayan mythology, we are living in the fourth world or creation, so as to speak. The last creation ended on a particular sequence of the long count calendar. That sequence will occur again on December 20th, 2012. It is a time for great rejoice for Mayan people because they think of it as the beginning of a new era and not ending of the world. Those of you who have a further interest, the idea of 2012 being the end of the world was actually first suggested by the New Age religionist Jose Arbeliss in his 1987 book, the Mayan factor, path beyond technology. Well, we don't know if the world will end or not, but Maya did. Some believe that by the 9th century, Maya had overexploited the environment around them to the point that they could no longer sustain a large population. Other Maya scholars argue that the warfare between the various cities would have caused the trade alliances to break down. The stature of the holy gods diminished, the trade is diminished, that complex rituals and ceremonies dissolved into chaos. Still further, some believe that a catastrophic environmental change, such as a long intense period of drought, could have caused the downfall of Maya. All these three factors, over-exploitation of land, endemic warfare, and drought, may have brought the downfall of Maya, but none of which can be proven. And hence, we reach the limitations of archaeology. It collects phenomena, but hardly, if ever, can scientifically isolate them. It can frame number of hypotheses, but rarely, if ever, scientifically prove. Leaving up to you whether to believe in it or not. But remember, fiction reveals the truth that reality obscures. Over to you.